Welcome back to the Mental Health Minute. I'm Dr. Emily Mayfield, a licensed psychologist. Thank you for watching this video and being a part of the Mindset Therapy family. For today's video, I'll discuss how you can stay strong during the silent treatment. The silent treatment is a tool of control and manipulation often used by the narcissist. Through the silent treatment, they can control communication flow while leaving you confused on what you may have done wrong. If you experience the silent treatment, I'll discuss three things to keep in mind to put the control back into your hands and away from the narcissist. But before we discuss that more, if you haven't already, please consider subscribing to my channel. I really appreciate all of you who have already subscribed, allowing this channel to grow. Also, comment below if there's a video topic you would like to see. When you're in a relationship with someone, communication is key to things going as smooth as possible. This isn't to say that good communication prevents conflict or disagreements from arising. However, it does allow for understanding of the issue so it can be resolved quickly and ideally prevented from happening in the future. When your partner doesn't communicate, it can lead to ongoing and worsening issues in the relationship. One response to conflict that not only shuts down all communication, but also prevents the ability to work through what happened is the silent treatment. While the silent treatment can be used by anyone at any time, it's often used by the narcissist as a way to control and manipulate their partners. The silent treatment is a passive-aggressive communication tactic that is meant to punish someone and for that person to be shown they have done something wrong. The silent treatment is passive aggressive because the actual issue isn't clearly identified to the alleged offender. Rather, the person being passive aggressive behaves in a way to demonstrate their unhappiness by not actually addressing what the issue is. So let's just take a quick look at an example of passive aggressive communication. If you're unhappy at your job but don't want to address your unhappiness with your boss or manager, you might come to work 15 minutes late every day. You show up just late enough to be noticed, but not late enough to get in trouble. By showing up late, you hope your boss or manager realizes how unhappy you are with your job. The problem is, you are leaving them guessing because they may notice you're late, but have no idea why. It could be for many different reasons. During this process, your actual concern for unhappiness isn't being addressed, and you're now just seen as someone who arrives late. You have behaved in a passive-aggressive way by not addressing the issue directly. The silent treatment from your narcissistic partner is meant to cut off communication with you to show you they are unhappy, but the absence of directly addressing the issue leaves you wondering what you did wrong. And you may not have even done anything wrong other than behave in a way the narcissist doesn't like, which is viewed as wrong by them. When the narcissist gives you the silent treatment, they are in control, and this is a manipulation tactic they use. By not discussing the issue, they can control how they interact with you and what you get from the relationship. This leaves you feeling helpless and out of control. No matter what you say or do, they will not communicate with you or even tell you why they are not talking to you. You feel more and more out of control as the time goes on. So how should you respond if you are the recipient of the silent treatment from the narcissist after a perceived slight? The three recommendations I'm going to give are for those situations where you believe your partner is using the silent treatment as a form of control and you've already tried to address the issue directly. So the first recommendation is don't apologize. When someone is not talking to you, it's natural to want to resolve the issue as quick as possible. This usually means apologizing for what you think you did wrong. However, when you're apologizing to a narcissist, you are telling them that you are the problem and they have done nothing wrong. This just sets up the silent treatment as an effective tool of control for future interactions. Unless you have knowingly done something wrong, don't apologize. The second recommendation is to not respond back with your own silent treatment. You will lose. The narcissist must be right and they lack empathy. They don't all of a sudden start communicating again because they realize you're upset. When you give the silent treatment back, you're telling the narcissist that what they are doing is upsetting you, and that is why you're shutting down. This only boosts their ego because their goal is to upset you. The last and most important recommendation is don't engage at all with the narcissist because this keeps power in the hands of the narcissist. When you apologize, go silent yourself, or otherwise comment on their silence, you keep the control in the hands of the narcissist. All of these actions acknowledge what they are doing, and it's important to remember that the narcissist thinks only of themselves. When you highlight how their actions impact you, they'll keep doing it to remain in control. The more out of control you appear to be, the more in control they feel. The silent treatment is a form of emotional abuse that is meant to control and manipulate. When used in this way by a narcissist, the goal is not to improve things in the relationship, but to have their partner admit their alleged wrongdoing and to change the partner's behavior in a way that supports how the narcissist wants them to behave. When you try to get communication restarted, you're only feeding their narcissistic supply and giving them renewed resources to continue to control and manipulate you. Don't provide the fuel to the future abuse that they will inflict on you. Comment below if you've experienced the silent treatment and what you did to get past this difficult period of silence from the narcissist. Also, if you enjoyed the content of this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you haven't already hit that subscribe button to be a part of the Mindset family, please do it. I look forward to seeing you at the next video.